So in this lecture, we're going to be talking about how to calculate the genetic relationship matrix. So you want to think of this matrix as a big N by N matrix, where N is your sample size. And each element of that matrix is going to contain the pairwise genome-wide genetic similarity between each pair of individuals in your sample. So if you've got N individuals in your sample, it's going to contain N choose two elements on the lower diagonal. So the genome-wide genetic similarity between all your pairwise combination of individuals. And so the way to think of these elements is like an average genetic correlation across the genome for individuals JK. So AJK, each element of A at row J, column K, your average genetic correlation between two individuals. And you can calculate that value using this, I guess, reasonably scary looking formula. But in this series of slides, I want to show you that this formula is not scary at all, and in fact is very intuitive. And so what I want to do is I want to draw an analogy between this formula here, which is like a genetic correlation, with the formula for a Pearson correlation coefficient, which looks like this here. So immediately by just eyeballing the two, you can see that there is some similarities. There's some differences as well, but really the top one is we're just doing a correlation across genetic markers between two individuals, whereas down here, I guess we're computing a correlation across N different samples. Okay, so let's have a look at the formula in more detail. Let's start off by looking at these elements here, the Xij and the Xik. So Xij is the dosage, so that's 0, 1, or 2, of the reference allele for the SNP, for SNP I, for individual J. Likewise, Xik is the dosage, 0, 1, or 2, of the reference allele for SNP I for individual K. Now, if you think about it, each of these dosages, so 0, 1, or 2, is distributed like a binomial variable. So if you remember back to first year statistics, binomial variable, that's like tossing a coin and counting the number of heads or the number of successes. Except in this case, each genotype consists of two trials, so two alleles, for example. And so we're counting the number of reference alleles, the number of successes in those two alleles, which can be 0, 1, or 2 for each genotype. So each of those dosages, binomial variable, 0, 1, or 2. And so you might remember from first year statistics that when you have a binomial variable, the mean or expected value for that variable is equal to the number of trials multiplied by the probability of success for each trial. So here we've got two trials. Remember, we've got two alleles. Probability of success, PI, where PI is the frequency of the reference allele for SNP I. And so the mean is going to be 2 times PI. So that's what you're looking at here in the formula. So essentially, you're taking an individual's dosage and you're subtracting the mean value from that dosage. What about the denominator? So again, recalling from first year statistics, the variance of a binomial variable is equal to N times p times 1 minus p. So again, here we have two alleles for each genotype. So n is 2. So it's 2 multiplied by the pi, which is the frequency of the reference allele, multiplied by 1 minus pi. So what you've got on the bottom of this formula is basically the variance of the genotype. And of course, we know the variance is standard deviation multiplied by the standard deviation, right? Then the last thing we do is, I guess we're kind of averaging that all across M genetic markers across the genome. So if I put up the formula again for the Pearson correlation coefficient, now you can see that these two expressions are extremely similar. Here we're dividing over M genetic markers, whereas here we're probably dividing over N in the different individuals. But you can see that the expression in the numerator and the expression in the denominator are exactly equivalent. In the next series of slides, I'm going to be talking about the variance components model underlying the GCTA software package.